Big 102.1, Louisiana's greatest hits. It is the Big Morning Show with Fast and Renee.
I can tell by the way you said that we need to celebrate National Coffee Day. It is.
I need coffee and I need cough medicine. Can I have both of those things today?
Actually,
together?
What we need starts at 7 o'clock this morning. We're going to kick off the party this weekend. Big weekend, homecoming, so much stuff. It is Thursday, and that means TBT.
That's right, Throwback Thursday, as always, presented by Cypress Bayou Casino Hotel. That starts at 7, but lots to do before, during, and after inside the Big Morning Show.
Wreaking havoc all over Florida. Oh, my gosh. Ian, what a storm. Several stories coming out. We will share what we can see and some of the insights that we have from people that we know. I was gonna try to sound like I was official. People we know on the ground. People we know that live there.
We had boots on the ground, but they floated away.
Yeah, no kidding. King Charles III. Is he comfortable in his crown? We'll take a look at that. And is there a new crown for a brand new fine artist?
So, where do you go for peace and quiet? Well, to see a movie, of course. All that and more coming up.
Today is September 29th, National Coffee Day. I've been celebrating National Coffee Day since I got up. I've had a couple of cream and sugar, a couple of black, an espresso, a cappuccino, a mocha latte, a frappuccino, a dark roast, a blonde roast, a cafe au lait with a double shot of mocha espresso, and I've been to the restroom 17 times. Woohoo! I love National Coffee Day.
I started to say I'll have what he's having, but maybe I changed my mind.
The Big Morning Show with Fast and Renee. Big 102.1.
Maybe one of the things you could do is stop going to the movie. Oh, wait. Maybe you already did stop going to the movies. Man, this is crazy.
Well, it's funny. You know, when you give the numbers, I remember what the numbers used to be.
Yeah.
They were like massively huge for weak movies. Now, they're not exciting for big movies.
Yeah, well, Sony's The Woman King and Warner Brothers' Don't Worry, Darling, this September's box office, lowest levels in 25 years.
Now, is that with adjustments for the value of the dollar?
Well, it doesn't count 2020 when Tenet accounted for like $86 million of the box office. Because it was the only movie playing.
Right.
But
one theater open in the country.
Yeah, I'm guessing $275 million grossed in North America. It'll be the first September since 1997 with a monthly total of less than $350 million. Isn't that crazy?
The industry has changed.
The industry has changed. Movies have changed. People's attitudes about going out. And the way that they, you know, watch entertainment, I say they, we watch entertainment.
Well, that's the thing. The entertainment options that we have as a public now, where we kind of talked about this yesterday, I think, about technology and being able to stream whatever you want at any time. It was 15 years ago was the wildest dream you could possibly have. I'm going to get on my TV and I want to watch
anything that I want.
I want to watch It's a Wonderful Life in July. Well, just type it in and there it is. I mean, you couldn't do that before.
You might have to pay $3.99 plus
tax, right.
You know, but
that's why I have Amazon Prime and Netflix and Hulu, and because like everybody else.
Of course, you know, the movie theaters may have some value.
Johnny wanted to be alone.
I'm always surrounded by too many people.
So Johnny found the one place on Earth he wouldn't bump into anyone.
I'm going to go to the movies.
Ticket sales were down, and an empty theater was just the thing Johnny needed to be alone for a while.
There's no one here.
Johnny was able to read, nap, and even eat in complete peace.
It's heaven. I mean, except for the stupid movie they keep playing.
Watch as one man finds the solitude he's always desired and go see At the Movies.
I'm the king of the theater.
Now play.
The Big Morning Show with Fast and Renee. Big 102.1.
We kind of dodged a bullet with the weather. You know, if you remember, I don't know, 10 days ago or so, when there was nothing there, and they said there would be something there. One of the early predictions was that what became Ian, would move into the middle of the Gulf of Mexico. And it didn't happen because, luckily for us, not so fortunate for our friends to the east, it got picked up by a front and moved off to the east more quickly. So it made landfall yesterday morning, a little south of Tampa, I guess, Sarasota area, and is still over Florida.
I mean, did it like stall when it hit the mainland?
It moved more slowly,
or whatever,
which is they thought was going to happen offshore. So luckily, it got onshore and then began to slow down.
I was looking at just some information. Jim Cantore got hit by a flying tree branch. I don't know if you heard about that. He was reporting.
I could have won money in Vegas.
That he was going to get hit by something.
You can bet on that. You can bet on that.
Really?
Yeah.
It also said that he got angry at some lightning. I mean, so Jim's having a bad day.
Time to go to the old weatherman's home. Is there such a place? Maybe I need to open one.
I don't know. Some of the weather reporters were actually wearing baseball helmets.
Yep.
Just to keep stuff from hitting them in the head. Are there concussion protocols in meteorology?
I think Cantore started that with a batting helmet a few years ago.
This is interesting and actually kind of a serious, it's weird, but kind of a serious sign. 21 Waffle House locations closed.
Ooh, that's, you know, things are very dangerous out in the world when the Waffle House closes.
Well, they're known for staying open no matter what.
Right.
And one of those places where, especially like first responders and all of the power trucks and stuff, they know they can go get a hot cup of coffee, a breakfast, whatever, and wait to be, you know, stationed to where they need to go for cleanup and repair and stuff. 21 Waffle House locations in Florida closed.
Did Disney close?
I was just trying to figure out if I could find that. I have to assume they did. I don't have that specific information, but at midnight last night, 2 million people in Florida were without power. In Fort Myers, where Fast and I actually have a good friend in Fort Myers, 96% of homes without electricity, the city not even able to respond to emergency calls coming in. I got a text this morning from our friend who said, "I feel like it's 1850."
Right, yeah. No electricity, yep. And he's not from the area. Moved down there recently, so he's not really used to this. I did let him know that I saw a whole bunch of power trucks on the interstate heading east yesterday, so that was good news. Disney World and Universal Studios did close in advance of Ian. So in the old days, they just stayed open.
Yeah.
And nobody went. So I guess they figured it was easier to save payroll by sending everybody home.
Yeah, let their people go home and get safe. Our prayers, our thoughts are with the folks in Florida. And as that storm continues to move, everyone in the path of Ian.
Thanks for listening to the Big Morning Show with Fast and Renee. Big 102.1.
But I think that the signature of Throwback Thursday will kind of right the ship and get me where I'm supposed to. I don't know where I am. Who am I? What am I doing here? That's what I feel like today.
Who's wine? What wine? Yeah. So, it is here. And we've got some really cool stuff coming up today. There is something happening. Please don't think I'm being foo-foo here. I'm not being foo-foo. But I have a story about art and art collectors. And it is not a foo-foo story. Wait, hold on. Hear me out. How many of us have a piece of artwork that was prepared and given to us by a child, whether it's our own child, grandchild, niece, nephew, neighbor's kid, godchild, that is precious? It's the most precious little work of art. I have one of the sweetest pictures that my granddaughter drew of, it's an Easter scene.
Right.
I treasure it. I mean, to me, it's the sweetest thing. I love it so much. It really means so much to me. But there is a 10-year-old kid who they're saying might be the next big thing in art. 10-year-old.
So what are they calling this kid?
Little Picasso.
Little Picasso. Not, you know, is it little, like Lil' Kim? Or is
I think
it
it's
little?
Like Lil, like Lil. Andres Valencia has already sold paintings in the six figures.
So is he a cubist? Does he do like the weird stuff? We haven't seen his artwork. We've just read about him, right? I tried to find some artwork pictures. I couldn't find it.
It says that he is inspired by Pokemon and Click and Play Army Act. I kid you not. Man. And it is little Picasso. Okay. He started replicating graffiti at the age of 4. Obviously, he's very, very talented. Some of the people who bought his work already include Brooke Shields, Sofia Vergara, Channing Tatum, Diane Keaton. I mean,
they have the money to invest in potential growth in the art world.
They do, and it's called My Modern Met. Fifth grade kid. Tough to recall an artist who has generated so much early career recognition, according to the New York Times. How bizarre is this story?
Can you imagine, though? So, I mean, I've been to auctions. Like, I do, you know, I do weird stuff. I collect stuff or whatever.
Right, yeah.
And I watch, like, the Barrett Jackson auction. I've never really watched, like, a true art auction. Like, never really sat down and watched when a Renoir is on the auction block or whatever. But there's a certain sound and feel. And then that's where the foo-foo comes in, right?
Well, I don't know how much I'm willing to bid for this 10-year-old Valencia.
Well, I'm the one that's like, well, let me pull out my wallet. Nope, I'm out.
Welcome to the 10-year-old kid artwork auction. Our first item up for bid is called Traced My Hand to Draw a Turkey. So, to some rich D-bag for $3 million. Our next piece is titled Scribbling in a Coloring Book from the artist's Blues Clues period. It's only in blue crayon because the artist ate the red one.
Of course.
Sold to the hedge fund idiot for $5 million. The next composition is called Birthday Card I Drew for My Mommy. This work was originally displayed at the Museum of Kitchen Refrigerator, right next to the piece named Upcoming Dental Appointment. Sold to Mr. Are You Out of Your Friggin' Mind? Finally, we have a 10-year-old's very confusing magic marker sketch titled Unicorn Rainbow Spider-Man Pikachu. I'll start the bidding off at $20 million. Sold to Channing Tatum.
The Big Morning Show with Fast and Renee, only on Big 102.1.
Aston, Keith Couillon Douillon. That's how they put it from Abbeville. Kim Walker, Nolan Mons from Scott. Also celebrating in Abbeville today, Bliss Dene Boutte and Charlotte Dore. Shantae LeBlanc from Brobridge and Kelsey Lampkin from Erath said that Kelsey's all excited about Comic-Con.
Oh, okay, so, awesome.
Yep. Right. If you've got a birthday or an anniversary, make sure you let us know tomorrow when we do the big list. We'll include the weekend, and we'll give away that cake from Keller's Bakery. Always something sweet cooking up, and a little sweet and beautiful in Youngsville.
Really easy to get birthdays to us, too. You can call us 337-406-1021. We do a post on Facebook pretty much every morning. And, of course, the website. Unless you're having internet problems or, well, it's weird weather or whatever, you can use that pretty much any time at big1021.com.
Let's Go Back in the Day is brought to you by Miss Mamie's Casinos, the original video poker casino in Acadiana.
It's September 29th, the greatest day ever. On the 29th of September, 1988, Mountaineer Stacy Allison became the first American woman to reach the summit of Mount Everest, proving once and for all that women are just as capable as men when it comes to doing something dangerous and unnecessary. Have a great September 29th, the greatest day ever.
Pretty funny.
I don't resemble that remark. John Rockefeller was declared the first American billionaire on this date, 1916.
Wow.
Yeah, isn't that crazy?
Wow.
The Tylenol poisoner.
Oh, yeah.
Claimed the first victims on this date, 1982. If you don't recall, there were 7 deaths in the Chicago area over a 2-day period that authorities determined had come from Tylenol capsules that had been laced with cyanide.
Never caught the person.
Nope, they never did. But it did change the way that many consumer products are sold. Safety seals.
Yes, and when you have a really bad headache and you have a new container of Tylenol, it's the most frustrating thing on earth when you're trying to get at it because you need it. No patience when you have a bad headache,
oh,
right?
No kidding. Your headache gets worse. Couple of things debuted on TV I think are of note. 1985, MacGyver on ABC. And Designing Women in 1986 on CBS.
I always thought that was the goofiest show. My mom loved it, though.
So many people, that's their all-time favorite show. That and Golden Girls. Jennifer Lopez having a wedding at... Oh, never mind. It was that was just her second husband. And... That was Chris Judd. And that is our look that. This morning, back in the day, brought to you by Miss Mamie's Casinos. You're going to love Miss Mamie.
Thanks for listening to the Big Morning Show with Fast and Renee. Big 102.1.
Again, it's also homecoming for the Raging Cajuns, taking on the Jaguars of South Alabama. And, you know, the competitions have happened. I had friend, my buddy Randy Rivera posted all these pictures yesterday of doing Paint the Town Red. And I was like, man, that was so much fun. Except for the people stuck in traffic because of them. But it really is a lot of fun. And it's a way that businesses get involved. And everybody in the community should be involved. UL is a huge part. I don't care if you're not a football fan. UL is a huge part of our economy and of our community, and it's very important. And most of us, at one point or another, either wandered on campus accidentally or went to school there. I went to school there, but I only wandered on campus accidentally.
Occasionally.
I didn't go to class. I mean, I was just there. But it's a lot of fun. This week is a whole lot of fun. The parade, of course, will happen on Saturday. I think Yell Like Hell still happens on Thursday night or Friday night. So lots of fun happening for UL. And Mike Desimo and the guys need some support. So go out and see the team.
Happy homecoming and go Cajuns.
Oh, can I do a side note about this weekend? You know, the Saints are in London.
Uh-huh.
They're playing the Vikings.
Right.
I saw a story that Jameis Winston's not practicing and Andy Dalton is probably going to be the starter on Sunday. At 8:30 in the morning our time. Just remember that. Game is at 8:30 Sunday morning.
You know, if Jameis Winston's going to play hurt every week, I'm glad he's taking some time off when he's in London and nobody's going to be awake.
Well, you know, it's rumor has it that he was in a taxi saying, look, kids, Parliament, Big Ben, over and over again, because he got stuck on Piccadilly. Never mind.
The Big Morning Show with Fast and Renee. Big 102.1.
It was on this date 233 years ago today, 1789, that Congress established what with the strength of several hundred men? Do you know?
Is it the Army?
The U.S. Army, that is correct, with the strength of several hundred men.
Sounds intimidating to me. Who's this?
This is Trey.
Hi, Trey. Did you guess or Google that?
I Googled it.
Well, you got it, and you're going to get to be our guest at Mendez's. Trey, congratulations.
Thank you.
Big Morning Show with Fast and Renee. Big 102.1.
What is happening in the land of the royals?
Who cares? I guess it's been long enough. I mean, we rested that while the queen was lying in state.
Yeah.
But now that she's, you know,
what's really creepy is that Who Cares may actually be at the palace. Evidently, King Charles III is busier than he's ever been. He's also the oldest he's ever been, because all of us are.
Yes. I'm older today than yesterday. How
exactly.
about you?
It's a very difficult career change for him.
Ridiculous.
Do you think perhaps he is having some second thoughts?
All this pomp and circumstance really stinks. Ministers, tell me what to say and think. My sons have reason to poison my drink. Yes, I really hate being king. Yes, I really hate being king. Yes, I really hate.
Thanks for listening to the Big Morning Show with Fast and Renee, only on Big 102.1. It's time for the Big Morning Show Inflation Fighters, brought to you by Pinhook Flea Market, saving you money every Wednesday through Saturday at 3131 West Pinhook Road.
We're living with inflation.
Here is today's tip from Fast and Renee.
We mentioned this a few weeks ago, that to be aware of the calendar could save you some money. Because when there are days that have been designated as a certain day, a lot of businesses will give, well, particularly today, perks. See what I did there? It is National Coffee Day. You're welcome.
Yeah.
And there are lots of ways today to get something free, especially if you're one of those people that has a budget for coffee every day, which I know a lot of people do.
Yeah, either free or in other cases, maybe discounted. So, you know, some places might have a dollar, a cup of coffee instead of whatever they normally charge or whatever. So give us a couple of specifics, if you've got them, of where today, if you're out on the road and if the location in your neighborhood is participating, you can get a free cup of coffee.
The Flying J Pilot Rest Stops are giving rewards members free coffee in any size.
Wow.
So if you've got the little card or whatever, if you travel a lot, I know a lot of people have those. Wendy's has a free small coffee deal with any mobile order. Burger King rewards members can get a free iced coffee if they order online. Panera Bread has a deal on their unlimited free coffee subscription, and that's actually a pretty good deal. $11 a month, but if you sign up today, you get your first 2 months free.
Locally, this is what I found just kind of searching real quick. Jet Coffee over on Johnston, south of the mall, heading toward Maurice. Any sized Jet Squad drink, hot, iced, or frozen, $2 off all day today. So any size, save a couple bucks. So if you go there anyway, save a couple dollars. But if you didn't know to ask for it, you might not get it. Or if you are driving by saying, well, I'm not going to stop today, Teddy, it might be the better day to stop.
You know what? It is one of those ways that just using your thinking, you can save money. You know, we're all fighting every day to try to stretch our dollar as much as we can. And that is why we bring you inflation fighting tips. And we thank our sponsor, Penhook Flea Market.
You know, and this, we mentioned before about following your favorite businesses to say, you know, getting their apps. Here's another example of it. Because if you follow these businesses, you might have known. But if you didn't know, that's why we're here. Inflation fighting tips, thanks to Penhook Flea Market. On Penhook Road, open Wednesday through Saturday.
Thanks for listening to the Big Morning Show with Fast and Renee, Big 102.1.